What's a movie scene that has scarred you for life? I watched the Maze Runner trilogy with my family. Spoiler alert now. I hate horror movies, but love to read Greek mythology, so I assumed it was something about Daedalus's labyrinth or something. It turned out to be a sci-fi horror trilogy about the flare virus, where people get infected via bites and scratches, and lose control of your mind, kinda like zombies, but fast, agile, and not dead. In the final scene, the main character throws a chunk of wood at the villain. He misses, and the villain says, "Missed, you little shtee." To which the main character responds, "Did I?" The wood hits a glass container which has two infected people in it. The glass container breaks, and the zombies come jumping out onto the villain's face and proceed to eat him alive, as he screams, and our main character runs out of the burning building. Notice how I call him main character, not hero. The Shining 1997, when little Danny walks into room 217, and sees the lady in the bathtub, absolutely horrified me for years. I saw that movie 2 weeks ago. That scene was so creepy that, if I didn't have a kitten sleeping on my lap, I would have left the room. I also wasn't fond of the scene with the blood flooding the room. Honestly, the way the scene pulled out in the original 1980 film was much better. Scene ends with Danny stepping in the room and we don't even know what was in there until later in the film, and even then, we still don't really know if it was even real or just in Jack's head. Showing the lady right away just ruins the suspense for me. Then again, the miniseries is my least favorite remake of all time, and the movie is my favorite of all time, so I guess, I'm sorry for wasting your time with my opinion, Princess Mononoke. I thought it was a kid's movie and I watched it really young. I used to have nightmares of the big boar that was turning into a demon, the red things were coming out of him. Don't forget Summon's head literally getting shot off with an arrow. Carrot, I was like 9. That was my favorite scene when that happens at the end. The two guys are riding up and one gets his head shot clean off, and the other just turns around and rides away without a word. For me, it's the wolf one I remember as a reason to never watch it again. That was the best part, and how I knew this was gonna be a special movie unlike the others. For me, it was when the forest spirit got its head cut off, and the black goo started seeping everywhere and killing everything. The scene from Event Horizon where they decrypt and view the video log from the ship's control panel and find out what happened to the original crew. I was like 12. It was scary. Good movie. I hope cosmic horror makes a comeback in the movie industry. Heck yeah, being alone and trapped up in space light years away from home really adds to the horror element. That one episode of Love, Death and Robots with the Lost Space Station was horrifying. Freaked me out when I first watched it, and I was 17 at the time. Apparently it was supposed to be longer, and they did film more, but I like that it was just a tiny snippet. Made it scarier. The extended version is not a pleasant experience. Not me, but my younger cousins really wanted to watch a scary movie, so I pulled out Coraline Weird Button Eyes thing, and was about to pop it in when they both whined that it was a kid's movie. It genuinely scared me as a kid, so I said fine, but I guess I added a bit of malicious compliance. I pulled out the movie that made me cry for an entire night and popped it in the DVD player, and watched as they both died inside as a scary Asian ghost lady stalked a reporter. If you haven't guessed, we watched The Grudge. I got grounded for like a month for scaring the poor little guys, and felt pretty bad for a while. Corrections. I saw RoboCop when I was 10. The hand scene was a grueler. For me, the toxic waste scene was worse. But yeah, the hand scene was nasty. Same. I kept my eyes closed on rewatch for 20 years afterwards. I only finally able to actually watch that bit in the last decade. As a kid it shocked me, because I was simply not expecting anything that gruesome. I saw it in the theater and I really had no idea what I was getting into. I think it was rated for 14, and up in Canada, and I was 11, and just got into the movie. One of my earliest childhood memories is me hiding behind the seat in front of me in pure terror at the cinema, when my mother took me to watch In the Land Before Time. I was about 5 years old at the time. Not scarred for life, but definitely the most memorable one. Never watched the film again either. In my adult life, the only scene ever that made my adrenaline pump and really shocked me was the infamous fire extinguisher scene in Gaspard Noé's Irreversible. perfectly executed scene, came out of nowhere, and looked extremely realistic for its time. Absolute kick in the teeth. When Judge Doom dips the little cartoon shoe in Who Framed Roger Rabbit? How about when he reveals his true identity, that voice? The way that scene terrified me as a child, lol. I can still hear him yelling and shrieking. His eyes. Jesus. You mean when he screams, just like this? When he is going under the steamroller was my nightmare. The entire thing. It's nightmare fuel. I was sad to realize I can't show that movie to the kids till they're at least 16, maybe 17. The scene in House of Wax, when that guy gets turned into a wax figure. The part where the tip gets snipped with the bolt cutters is way worse for me. A finger, but yeah, that's pretty bad too. Oh, is it a finger? It's been like 10 years or so since I've seen it. I just remember it making me cringe. Yeah, he glued her lips shut too. I remember watching it when I was about 14 and feeling really disturbed. Paris Hilton had a pretty violent death scene in that movie. The horse dying in quicksand in The Neverending Story. That one is so horrible. I still cry every time I see it. Don't let the sadness take you, Artex. R.I.P. Artax, M30, and still cry during that part. I guess the swamp of sadness gets everyone. He just gave up. The saddest scene ever. My kids still talk about this scene. Sorry I scarred you, bad mommy. Came here to say this. Forever traumatized. Well, when I was 7 years old and home with a fever, my sister showed me Sweeney Todd, the 2007 movie version. If you don't know what it's about, look it up. The part that scarred me was when Sweeney Todd threw Mrs. Lovett in the furnace and watched her burn. I was so tired and dizzy that I just laid down on the couch and cried. I guess it didn't hurt me too bad though, because it is now my favorite movie and I've watched it about 14 times since then. I have it on DVD. Fire in the Sky, when he gets abducted in the woods. First movie I actually remember seeing as a kid. I had snuck downstairs and walked in right on that scene. Totally forgot about that movie. That needle going into his eye. I think that's the original reason why I never wanted to try contacts. Came here for the eye needle scene. Yup. I watched that when I was a kid. I wouldn't eat jelly for months after that movie. Oh, it was so scary. Jurassic Park and the Jeep scene. I was 3 and my dad took me to see it in theaters. I remember screaming save me mommy and trying to get away, hanging on to my mom's neck and facing away from the screen. I still can't watch any of those movies without hiding my face or leaving the room or pacing while plugging my ears. Also, growing up I didn't have monster under my bed, but a velociraptor in the closet. Could not sleep with the closet door open. Not sure if this counts, but there was this scene on SpongeBob where a butterfly landed on their faces. It showed a really zoomed in picture of a real butterfly, and it looked really creepy. I was afraid of butterflies for a couple years after that. Lol. From what I remember, the gimmick was that the zoom in wasn't even a butterfly. Or maybe the sound wasn't of a butterfly. Don't remember exactly, but I remember it was something like that. In Rambo, the latest Old Man Rambo, there is a scene of the bad soldiers raiding a village. In one scene, a woman is holding her child in her arms. A soldier running past grabs the child and throw him into a burning hut just because. Also in War of the Arrows, a similar scene. Soldiers running amok. A soldier grabs a baby from a woman and nonchalantly throws the baby into a well. Then grabs the woman and hauls her off to be prisoner with no chance of her saving the baby. Watership Down, when the plow was ripping the rabbits up out of the ground, who were all wedged so tightly in those tunnels trying to escape they couldn't even move or breathe. Then the ground was running red with their blood. E.I. Up. Great kids movie. The fight scene, where they are clawing at each other's throats with their hind paws, the hound viciously shaking a now dead rabbit, just fuck that movie. The scene from Don't Breathe with the turkey baster still causes me to gag even now. Lol, my boss introduced me to this movie. We all sat down one day at work and watched it while on the clock. Everyone was like, wow, gross, but I blurted out, dang, I want some froyo. Never seen the film. Would you mind elaborating on what happened? I'll just link you to it. In one of the Persona 3 of us where someone says that one is faced with death, you realize your purpose in life. I think Dorkun said it. This helped me define what I wanted to do in life. Art. This helped me get through my existential dread after my grandfather's death, which led me to stay up later at night and frick up my sleep schedule. Thanks, Persona 3 team. The curb scene in American History X. Oh yeah, geez, I almost forgot that one. It is brutal. Hard to believe that there could be people like this in the world. Have you taken a look around lately? Or throughout history? I know they exist, but it racks my brain thinking that people can be so evil. All scenes that included Muppets in the Labyrinth with David Bowie. My cousin let me watch it as a 5-year-old in his native language. Developed a phobia for any Jim Henson Muppets because of that movie. Same cousin also made me watch El Laberinto del Forno around the same age, and the scene where Ophelia is chased by the pale man still gives me nightmares. The Mummy 1999, where Imhotep has his tongue cut out, wrapped in bandages, and tossed into a casket filled with scarabs. Watching those bugs pour onto that poor guy's body was terrifying. Looking back, for such a light-hearted movie, The Mummy was super violent. Still L9 Vet, and Ref 7 SE to see the Tom Cruise one. The right. I cried in the movie theater, and had to leave. My boyfriend at the time thought I was being ridiculous. I agree, that is, was kind overkill, that we had to leave, but that stuff seriously freaks me out. I never tried watching it again and probably never will. I'm have zero interest in any movie that's remotely similar. I absolutely hate the scene where they cut off the guy's ear in Reservoir Dogs. I can't even hear that song without shuddering. The coolest thing about that scene is that you don't actually see the guy's ear getting cut off. It's almost worse that way. Cable's Super Sounds of the 70s Weekend just keeps on trucking. In it 2017, when Pennywise bites George's arm off. I'd never seen a movie actually show something that horrible happening to a kid, let alone in the very first scene of the movie. I've read the book, and knew exactly what was gonna happen, but something about it being shown so explicitly fucked me up real good.